is Kutso. She's a chartered accountant, CFO of a consulting engineering company. She's a property investor, a very proud mother of three, and her focus areas are multi-lets, student accommodation, sourcing, and capital flips. During lockdown, these are the three areas that she was able to get success. Now, guys, the reason why I'm putting this up is to show you that when you've got a strong why and when you're committed to taking charge, these are the results you can get. So Kutso was able to complete her second buy-to-let in Lone Hill. She received 100% loan-to-value from Absa at 7.25%. She's got two multi-lets offers accepted, and I think they're in the region of 30 to 40 million rand multi-let. So we're talking big investments here. And she's done two back-to-back deals which don't require any money. She's been able to capitalize on that. And that was all during lockdown. Before I call her up, let me just show you one deal. This is her most recent buy-to-let opportunity that she closed in Lone Hill. You can see that it's just a very nice normal apartment. On the top left, you're seeing the high-level property values. So the asking price is 740. She offered 617. She got a yes, right? A nice 10% discount. On the bottom right-hand corner, you're seeing the cash flow, the rental numbers. So her income is 85,000. Ugh, sorry. 85,000 would be nice. It's 8,500. She's put some money away for voids, because remember, it's going to be vacant at some point. She's got a bond repayment. She's got some insurance, rates and taxes, levies, and she's put some money away for maintenance. She's walking away with a nice 700 rand passive income. Now, 700 rand is not going to make you financially free. But how many of those do you need to start having a bit of a side hustle to have some income that in case you lose your job, you've still got something to rely on? And also remember, she got 100% loan for this, which means she didn't have to put much money down. She maybe put some bond and transfer costs down, maybe 20,000 rand, and she's making 700 rand per month. Leverage, the power of leverage. Now, without further ado, I'm going to ask my guest to come and join us. Let's just see if she's there. I'm going to unmute you. Good, so over to you.
Evening, Lawrence. Can you hear me?
Yes, all good.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much for the warm introduction. I'm really honored and grateful to share this platform with you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for sacrificing your time to join us this evening. Before I share with you my journey on how I found a way to buy my first investment property during these hard times, let me first start by sharing with you my why. We all have dreams and aspiration on where we would like to be one day. One of mine, obviously, is to get out of the rat race, to own my time. And they say one need to have a vision greater than where you are today, and that vision should scare you. My higher purpose and vision is to have an entrepreneurial and leadership academy school focusing specifically on the ethical and authentic leadership from primary level all the way to high school. This will be my way of giving back to society and to develop leaders and entrepreneurs of the future. I truly believe that the greater my success, the greater my ability to help others. Why property? Well, I always had a passion for property, specifically being a developer, building commercial buildings such as shopping centers, block of apartments, et cetera. So my passion of property really grew over a period of time. So why during the lockdown? Well, I generally have a very busy schedule with my job. So my day job as a CFO is very demanding and it takes so much of my time. I even have to, take work home and work late hours. So to add on that, I spent the last 2 years studying my master's degree, which I completed last year. Now, when I started, lockdown started, the industry in which I work, which is the built environment, was hardly hit by the lockdown. And the level of activity drastically reduced, and I found myself with more time at my disposal to invest in my wealth creation. Unfortunately, I was also one of the people who were really affected by the lockdown. My employer announced that our salaries was going to be reduced by 30% at the beginning of the lockdown, and that happened all the way from April up until August. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that was, my only source of income. I did not have any other income. And I had to use my savings, to fund my master's degree. And I had to resort to whatever was left in my savings, to make up for the 30% reduction in my salary, which obviously was not enough. So it was really, really tough. And how did I get started? like Lawrence mentioned, property education, knowledge, knowledge, knowledge. And knowledge is only power if you apply it. So around June last year, my partner told me about this property education offered by Legacy South Africa. After reading about what the, you know, the course was about, I was very excited and I really didn't think twice about attending. Lawrence was facilitating the session in Pretoria, and I was so inspired to learn about how one can become a professional property investor. And I did not hesitate to sign up for the course. So I invested in the property education. I learned a lot about what a property can offer you. Investing in this education broadened my horizon, and it was the best decision ever. So I completed my education, and at the same time, I was busy with finalizing my dissertation, which I submitted in December last year. And it was time for me to plan the holiday for the kids, and I took them for a first overseas trip. And a few months later, coming back, COVID-19 hit South Africa and the world, and we're in lockdown. Now, during that time when I finalized my education and I submitted my dissertation and I have all this knowledge, I did not apply it. I did not do anything. Now, having so much time at my disposal, I never had to put time, you know, to really practically start my property journey and apply what I've learned. And this really hit me very hard because I had taken a decision earlier that I could be having, you know, had I started earlier, I could be having an investment property that was generating a positive cash flow and giving me passive income. And that could have gone a long way during these hard times because it was much needed money. Then I had a mind shift and I went back to my property education material to recap everything that I've learned. I attended a lot of webinars. There were a lot of free webinars during the lockdown. And in the process, I registered for a 12-week course in property development and the Mindpower course. And I wrote my vision down. You know, I had to come back to myself and I have to do an introspection. I wrote my vision down. I wrote my mission statement, my goals, and all my short-term goals, you know, and updated my vision board. And I wrote the affirmations. And every morning, ladies and gentlemen, I'm so diligent, you know, in really reciting my affirmations. And just to share with you a few in terms of my affirmations that really, really encouraged me and really changed me from within is, you know, I would say every morning that every day I take action. I'm living my life with purpose and passion. I experience gratitude for everything I have in my life, and I can achieve anything I set my mind to. Prosperity is drawn to me. The more I give, the more I receive. And the more I receive, the more I give. And I'm deserving of abundance in my life, and I'm firmly determined to achieve anything I set my mind to. Now, ladies and gentlemen, saying this affirmation really, really made a huge transformation from within. My mindset was changed, and I felt positive, encouraged, motivated, and ready to conquer the world. So I attended the webinar hosted by Lawrence around May this year. And at the end of the webinar, he spoke about a coaching program that they have. And I knew that all I was missing was a property coach. And I remember that during my property education, they spoke about the importance of having a property coach. And I made a decision to sign up for a coach. And that was the best decision and the wisest decision I ever made. And what actually made this a success is that, number one, I made a decision to invest in my future. And I said to myself, if I put the same level of commitment, dedication, diligence, and passion and energy that I had towards my career and academics in my property journey, I knew that I can never go wrong because I was so hungry for the change. I knew the impact of not having a second income, what it can do to you. So I took a massive, massive action. And I have a program twice a week where I actually check out deals on property website. I analyze deals. I run my numbers, I contact estate agents, I find out what's happening, and all of these are aligned to my strategy. So during the lockdown, before they could actually uplift the restrictions on the real estate, you know, I had already prepared and really looking into my strategy, planning what I needed to do. I used my property app, I subscribed to Lightstone, the TPN, everything that Lawrence has spoken about, doing the due diligence, all of that I did. And on 1 June, when they actually uplifted the restrictions, I had already made appointments with a few estate agents and I went and I viewed property. And remember, this was my first experience. I went and I really put into action everything that I've learned. You know, I had my camera ready. I was looking for defects because I knew that all of these things, if I look and follow to the T what I've been taught, they will actually influence in terms of what my offer is on the properties. So even today, I still apply the same level of consistency and I've achieved a lot in such a short space of time. And I'm really, really proud of my achievement. Now, just to tell you how I got started is that one of the investors in the network group actually put out there that they are looking for somebody to source them a deal. So they were very specific in terms of the ROI they were looking for, the gross yield they were looking for, the areas that they were looking for. And I did my research and I had all this line up in terms of based on what the investor wanted. Then I went out, I viewed the properties, and I made, you know, those offers, or I actually secured, you know, the selling price. And in this process, I actually found my first deal, interesting enough, and that's how I got my first deal. But just to also share with you that after I went through the property education, I also had my structure in place. So I registered a company that I knew that when I get my first deal of buy to let or multi let, I want to do them via the company. And the back to back or the property flip, I wanted to do in my personal name. Now, one of the things that I consistently apply all the time is the 7 golden rules of coaching that I was taught during the property education. And ladies and gentlemen, those golden rules are: number one, you make money when you buy. You make money when you buy and not when you sell the property. Now, what does that mean? It means that the offer that you make, as much as it's a cheeky offer, it must be an informed cheeky offer after performing all your due diligence, deal analysis, and running the numbers. And that number, ladies and gentlemen, must always be below the market value of the property, because that means that you do have equity in that deal. Number two, always have 2 exit strategies, because you never know, things might change and you must always be prepared. A good property investor always has 2 exit strategies. Number three, buy for a qualified demand. You need to know who you are buying the property for, who is your tenant, who is your kind of your customer. So you always must have that in mind. And follow the money. An example I remember they gave us at the property education was an example of Starbucks or Curo schools. You know, where Curo is, you will know that, especially if your interest, your strategy is around the buy to let or multi-let, you know that you want to buy a property around an area where there are schools, where especially it's a family and it's easy. So always follow the money. And number 5, which is what Lawrence touched on, become a money raiser. Find the deal and raise the money, and always be professional in everything that you do. So every entrepreneur needs to be a money raiser. So you need to sell your dream to somebody else. Number 6, be safe and be legal. Don't sign anything that you don't understand. If an estate agent gives you an OTP, don't sign it on the dot. Take your time. If you've got a property attorney and you want them to go through it, do that. Make sure that you understand what you are signing and always make sure that it's legal all the time. And lastly, and importantly, take massive action. Nothing won't happen by itself unless you take the action. And I have seen that if you take the action, things start to move and you're much closer to realizing your dreams. So what are the lessons that I've learned through this journey? Is that opportunities are everywhere. And there is so much abundance, ladies and gentlemen, out there. The more you are out there, the more you see that there is just so much abundance. Even during this challenging times, believe me, people are so distressed. A lot of sellers that I found during my journey is that they cannot afford the bond or they have lost their jobs. Some of them, they're actually retiring. You know, it's becoming so expensive to actually maintain and manage the property. And always when you buy a property or when you do your due diligence, always ask, what is the reason for selling? Because that, ladies and gentlemen, you can use it to your advantage. And you can also use it to make sure that you structure your deal, in because there's so many creative ways of structuring your deal. So it's very important to know the reason why they're selling and if there's a bond on there on the property, because also on Lystone report, you can also see if there's a current bond, and always ask the question, you know, because there are a lot of ways of structuring the deal where you don't actually have to use your own money. And have the right mindset, persist, no matter how tough it is, never give up. Because if you're giving up, you're actually giving up on your dream, on your why. And get a property coach. You need that sounding board. You need to surround yourself with people that have walked through the journey, that have experience, and you can soundboard a lot of ideas. You know, you also, number one, you need to know what you want so that when you have a property coach, they can guide you to what you want in your strategy. And learn to walk away if the deal does not make sense or it does not meet your risk appetite. Don't just buy emotionally. Learn to walk away. If it's the numbers don't make sense, ladies and gentlemen, just walk away. There'll always be another deal. And use your time efficiently, like Lauren says. Make a verbal offer before you go. Before you go out there, just get a sense of whether this offer will be palatable to the seller. And I've applied the same principle. In the multi-lets deals, that the offers that have been accepted, I use the same thing. I made a verbal offer. Those questions that Lawrence took us through, I asked the very same questions to the estate agent. I did my homework. And I only went when I knew that what I put verbally as an offer, it's likely to be accepted. And it was accepted. And also learn to negotiate strategically, like I've mentioned, you know, check out the reasons why the seller is selling, the conditions of the property, and all of those things you can use to negotiate your offer price and the Lystone information that is there. And ladies and gentlemen, the real estate business or the commercial real estate, it's about relationship. It's all about relationship building, build relationship, have relationship, because once you are in the network, you've got a property coach, they have so much network. They can link you up with so many people. Even the power teams, they are former students who are, a success, who have walked the journey. You now starting to have the context, things now start to make sense. And your estate agents also build relationship with them. Check out on them what they've got. Just to share with you, one of the back-to-back deals, it was actually through a relationship with an estate agent. Before it was listed, they actually contacted me and say, I remember when we met, you did say that you do capital flips. So I have this property. Do you want to come and have a look at it? You know, I ran my numbers. I did my due diligence and then I went to view the property. And that's how I got the deal, through the relationship. People need to know what you do, what you're looking for, and that you are there as the property investor. Now, just to share with you my key advice in this property journey, follow and apply the basic property principles all the time. You'll never go wrong. Always run your numbers and do not be an emotional investor. Be creative in how you structure your deals. You know, use OPM, other people's money. Property gives you options. And be patient and weed out all the negative thoughts or the customer mindset. Now, what is a customer mindset? A customer mindset is a person with a mindset that is focused on the cost of something instead of the benefit of something. They focus on whether or not they can afford something instead of what benefit that something can bring. They believe that spending money will result in less money. A person with a customer mindset immediately start to count themselves out, and they are intimidated by a cost of a real estate. You know, like Lawrence mentioned, the sum of the multi-lets is a $30 million deal. You know, my mindset was not a customer mindset. I was not intimidated by that amount. I did not even ask myself, how am I going to get that amount? Will I be able to be approved? You know, and as a result of this, what tends to happen now when you have a customer mindset is that you block, you know, you start to have a mental block. And this mental block, unfortunately, it is detrimental to in real estate because being mentally blocked, you won't be able to consider creative ways of financing your deal, like seller financing, as an example, which you can actually use to finance your first deal. And see and visualize possibilities, you know, opportunities and abundance, like I said, they're everywhere. Only you have the power, ladies and gentlemen, to create your wealth. Remember, you are the master of your destiny, and be intentional in what you do. What you put in is what you're going to get out. And the key to long-term success, consistency. Consistency. Enjoy what you do and have a passion for it, and the results will be so rewarding. I just want to leave you with the last words from Anthony Robbins. He says, talk about something, it's a dream. Vision it, it gets exciting. Plan it, it becomes possible. And schedule it, it becomes real.
Thanks for watching another video with us. I hope you enjoyed yourself. If you're interested in learning more about how you can become financially free through property, here are two steps. Firstly, please go and get a copy of my book. You can get it at Exclusive Books, Amazon, or Take a Lot. If you're interested in getting more practical with property, perhaps you want to join our online university or you want to get a one-on-one coaching experience, please go to my website, www.lawrencebull.com, and don't forget to subscribe.